Here we have these virtual agents with the shape of sharks. They have a visual system that spans 180 degrees and that detects movements of salient elements in the visual field. Moving salient elements can be other sharks or fish, but they can also be elements of fixed objects which move in the shark's visual field as the shark moves. The sharks have a tendency to move towards the most salient elements in their visual field because we implemented a positive behavioral preference for making salient elements become even more salient. When a shark reaches an object, it can enact a specific interaction with that object. For example, it can eat a fish, which it loves, or it can bump into a wall, which it dislikes. It can even cuddle with other sharks, which it enjoys. So let's see what happens. There is an initial learning phase in which the sharks learn to master their sensorimotor contingencies. Very soon, they become able to reach salient objects and to experiment the possibilities of interaction afforded by these objects. They explore flowers, salient parts of walls, fish, and other sharks. See that they learn to avoid walls, and they learn to cuddle with each other. The important point here is that we did not encode predefined knowledge about the objects that the shark may encounter. Predefined knowledge of the world is called ontological assumption. The absence of ontological assumptions makes developmental algorithms easily transposable to robots interacting with the real world full of unexpected objects. This is a crucial difference with traditional AI and machine learning, which require a predefined model of the world.